Esto es HR 4437. ¿Qué es para usted? ¿Cómo le afecta o le beneficia su vida? ¿O le beneficia su vida? ¿O le beneficia
su vida? HR 4437 will criminalize millions of immigrants. Anyone in U.S. illegally will be subjected not only for deportation but as imprisonment as well.
U.S. citizens married with undocumented immigrants could be convicted of aliens. First driving this to an appointment could be convicted of transporting aliens.
It deputizes local law enforcement officials to enforce federal immigration laws over the objections of many such officials who believe that this authority undercuts their ability to protect the public safety.
It greatly expands the definition of smuggling in a way that severely penalizes innocent acts of kindness.
It mandates a broad-reach employment verification system that requires employers to retroactively verify the employment status of employees who have been employed for years.
It greatly expands mandatory detention and expedited removal, potentially imprisoning millions of people and generating huge costs to the taxpayer while accomplishing little in the way of deterring migration.
It severely reduces due process rights for illegal immigrants in a way that dramatically undercuts basic principle for American justice.
It expands the definition of aggravated felony, rendering legal immigrants convicted of minor offenses past ineligible for immigration benefits, including nationalization.
Those negatively affected by this will inevitably be American families
who could face separation.
It also mandates that churches, NGOs, and other involved in workforce development pre-screen potential job applicants before referring them to job a procedure that is likely to result in employment delay and possibly discrimination.
HR 4437 has recently passed in the House of Representatives and will now be on the Senate floor. President Bush has already expressed his support of this legislation.
Por tu maldito amor, no puedo terminar con tantas penas. Quisiera reventarme hasta las venas. Por tu maldito amor, por tu maldito amor.
It's yet another act of racism against gente.
Because it'll set a precedent that will allow the federal government to go after all brown-skinned individuals or Latinos.
They will be the ones that will be targeted by police officers, by Border Patrol agents.
We all look like Arabs, right? You know, it's like, that's what I think.
En primer lugar, esta ley viola los derechos humanos, ¿no? Viola el derecho más humano, el derecho a trabajar, a vivir en paz, a ser tratado como una persona, no como un animal.
No human being is illegal. There's no such thing as an illegal human being.
Do you think this law is necessary?
This law is unnecessary. I feel that it's an injustice that has a lot of consequences, not only in this community, but throughout the nation.
It will also affect the everyday citizens that go out and purchase, you know, just about anything that they can get at a grocery store to feed the family. So.
Mi pueblo nada más se dedique a trabajar duro, a ganar poco, a los trabajos más difíciles, más cansados.
If we have less workers picking the food we eat, that means less money being circulated. Less money means, you know, bad times.
You know, we're the backbone to this economy. We are the backbone to the U.S. Without us, they can't survive.
I work in schools that the majority of the student body are undocumented.
For us, as educators, we're supposed to provide an education for anybody who comes here without asking them if they are, why they're here. They're here and that's what we care about.
My role as an educator is to provide a safe space for the students to learn about the law, to become educated on the law, and to learn more about the type of effects that they'll be feeling.
It's like when you drop a pebble in water, it's gonna have an effect everywhere. Even if you can't see the ripple, it's still having an effect on everything.
Becoming educated empowers you. So that's my way of empowering the students.
What area of the Coachella Valley do you think would be affected the most?
It's gonna affect the eastern Coachella Valley and the unincorporated communities of Riverside County the most.
But in reality, the biggest industry in the Coachella Valley is the resort industry.
All the economic sectors are intertwined with immigrants who are working, with papers and without papers.
At the same time that they're telling us as immigrants, you know, you need to have papeles and you need to be documented or else you can't be in the States, they can't do without us.
We're always at the constant threat of losing our rights, especially after 9/11. And this is another infringement on those rights.
And there is fear as it is right now, you know, and just putting more fear into us that you don't have any rights, you don't belong here, go back to your country, and then it's gonna be chaotic.
If it passes, then it's gonna, and you know, I think we're gonna see a lot more political activism.
I believe the only people that can actually change this would be the youth. We need to organize and mobilize our sectors to fight these things, the better it is for all people.
Creo que es bien importante plantar la semillita, y el hecho de que a través de esto se les está plantando a ustedes la semillita, hay que esperar a ver qué fruto sale. Y, no, y lo que están haciendo ahorita ustedes, de tratar de educarse ustedes mismos y tratar de educar a otras personas, se me hace una cosa increíble, se me hace el arma más fuerte que podemos tener, y eso es lo que ustedes tienen que estar haciendo ahorita, una, estar bien aquí adentro, saber qué pasa alrededor de ustedes y cuidar su comunidad.
Que tratan de impedirnos llegar, pero no lo consiguen. Manda tu refulgencia, Señor, por mares y desiertos, para que ya ni el frío ni el calor dejen más muertos. Estamos en peligro de perder la vida, y aquí no nos podemos quedar, no queda otra salida. San Pedro eres el santo patrón de todos los mojados, concede la legalización al indocumentado.